Michael Schumacher had struggled to reach the heights for which he was famed during his second stint as a Formula One driver. But at Monaco in 2012, the German drove an utterly scintillating lap to take what would have been the final pole position of his career. A grid penalty for a previous infringement dropped him to sixth on the grid, but it took nothing away from what had been a superb performance and a reminder to all of the genius behind the wheel. Five European Grand Prix, Schumacher was hunting down Jean Alesi, going wheel to wheel in the fight for victory. Then, with three laps to go, Michael made his move.
Yes! Michael Schumacher takes the lead in the Grand Prix of Europe and the Benetton team go berserk with delight.
A fantastic overtake around the outside of the chicane gave him the race win, and topped off an incredible drive that had seen him take 25 seconds out of Alesi in the 15 laps prior to his pass.
So if I make it to win with three stops, it's a lot for me,
was able to match the pace of race leader and eventual winner Damon Hill. The Benetton driver fighting his way home to finish in an excellent second place. Schumacher was chasing victory at Spa-Francorchamps in 1992. In changeable conditions, Michael felt the time was right to switch to track tyres, and it was an inspired decision. Once those who had made the stops, Michael had taken the race lead.
I don't know why, but when I was on the motor today, I thought that I'm able to win this race. And I think my dream doesn't come up. And then suddenly the situation changed, I went in for dry tires, and it was absolutely at the right moment. I really can't describe it. It was something crazy.
Fighting Fernando Alonso for the 2006 World Championship, Schumacher delivered a stunning performance at the Brazilian Grand Prix that matched the most memorable of his race victories. Alonso on lap 9 dropped him to the back of the field and almost arrived there, but he refused to give up, passing nearly the entire field on his way back to fourth place, finishing just 24 seconds off the race win. He missed out on the Drivers' Championship, but he won all the plaudits in his final race for Ferrari. Schumacher made his debut with the Jordan team at the 1991 Belgian Grand Prix, standing in for the team's regular driver, Bertrand Gachot. The 22-year-old German was immediately on the pace, and he qualified seven fastest four places higher than his experienced teammate, Andrea De Ceseris. Sadly, his race would be cut short on the opening lap with clutch failure, but this one qualifying session had already done enough to attract the attention of other teams and earned him an immediate switch to Benetton.
The rest were very happy with the result. Yes, I'm really. The car feels really good. It makes a lot of fun to drive, and also for the time, I'm really happy here.
To give himself a chance of beating the McLarens. This lap, he stormed to the race victory, thanks to a combination of team strategy and one of his finest drives.
I mean, the dream about the ideal wheel. Oh, there's no stress,
but having been caught out in a wet-dry qualifying session, Schumacher started in 16th place on the grid in Belgium in 1995. However, come race day, he mastered the
I'm not